wrap up. We'll try to stay around as much as we can. But here's what I want to do. I'm going to ask each one of our panelists to give you one takeaway as they look at this and think about what you can do or what one thing that you might need to know to go home there. What would that be? So we'll start at the end.
I can tell you what I would do. Take away from this, I want you to be cognizant as reporters of what your middle-level administrators are going through, because they're getting pressure from both sides. I've been both a low-level administrator at the OSU, and I've been a faculty member and doing all sorts of things and managed not to get thrown out 25 years, which is semi-miraculous, I would say, right now. Some of the things that you have covered. So your government officials would not have been showing up today if they didn't care about what they're doing. So occasionally, they need to ask them why something is not done. Look into the case about why the minutes are not up. Ask first. And then if something as simple as the draft or get the tape recording would have solved it, ask. And this is what I tell my students when they're talking to BSU administrators. I said, the very last thing we want to do is to have file an open records request. It's the very last thing we ever want to do. We need to get the folks to talk to us. And what we have discovered, what has really worked at the university level, is social media. So we're working on a story right now about overcrowding on the bus system. And I'm assuming DOT would do the regulatories on the buses, where they have too many students on these buses. They're in front of the little black line that you're not supposed to stand in front of. And the administration is saying, no, they're not overcrowded. We never turned anyone away. And she's telling me this. I said, how do you know? She says, I'm linking to the database. I said, you know, thank you. So what we've done with social media is we have these kids tweeting. I said, okay, I'm on the bus. There's no, we can't get seats. Here's people. Here's our photos. Somebody standing in front of the long line. Here you go. And that's making the administration respond. And that the use of social media to get authorities to respond is probably the second takeaway. I thought I had. I'm a professor. So second takeaway I would get, social media, but listen to the folks on the other side. They have a story to tell you. Don't simply assume they're doing stuff simply because they're right. That's 99.9% of the time not the case.
Mine's a little bit simpler, but really the academic. I would say keep going, even when you get the no and the pushback from the public agency. I have to say that you all shame me. I mean, I put a lot of time and professional energy into this, but the work that you guys are doing is amazing. So I would say keep going, keep doing, keep fighting the good fight, because I'm impressed by everything I've heard today. So thank you all.
Yeah, I try to have a low threshold of indignation. But I try to temper it. Here is my problem. And I want Denise to hear this too. There is a galaxy. With all of y'all, Bobby, I want to say hi to you later on too. There is just a galaxy of stuff out there that I so much want to report on, write about, and we do not have 1,300 people up in the New York Times. We is a constant picking and choosing where you're going to weigh in on, what you're going to do, what you're going to tackle. I just got back to my desk to find an answer to an open record request right there. I mean, so don't be smart about what you go after, what you tackle, and remember that there is a network. There are other people out there who have dealt with what you're dealing with, are going to deal with you. They're experts out there. Don't feel like you're in a vacuum. There's help out there. Other writers, other reporters, listserv, or whatever, there are other people out there who can help.
But CBS did, and I was just thinking, why couldn't the Telegraph?
Well, we have. We can make your case. And I want to talk to you before I go. Anyway, I don't want to talk too much. There you go.
Kind of piggyback on what Obie said, I had a real good friend that actually was an ombudsman for open meetings and open records in Tennessee, and she just left the state comptroller's office and is going on to different kinds of advocacy, but all of you Second Amendment folks will understand this. she said we need to be using a rifle with a scope instead of a shotgun. So it always helps to be very targeted in what you're doing, to be very specific, to deal with one issue at a time. Don't make everything this scattergun approach, trying to solve all the world's woes in one fell swoop. If you have a records request, be very targeted, be very specific, know what you want. It's always better to know what you want and what you're going to get before you get it. You'll hear people say it's always best to not ask a question if you don't know the answer. Well, be very specific about what you're looking at. And when you confront public officials, and you should, and we all should, and newspapers should, let's know exactly what it is. Let's do our homework as we go into it. Here are my other takeaways. You've already got them. First of all, understand that, and please go home. In your newspaper, on your blogs, on your websites, and make sure that all local officials understand that there is never a requirement for them to go behind closed doors, to go to the bathroom. That they are not required to do executive session. Every time they do it, it is a choice. Number two, there is absolutely no prohibition that would prohibit a county, a city official, a school board member for speaking their mind, for expressing their point of view, or for disclosing information, as long as it is not proprietary information for personal gain. That's all the ethics code is going to prohibit them from saying. They can tell you what happens. And then finally, there is no protection afforded public officials just because they know, have heard of, or believe that attorneys exist in the world. I want to thank, go ahead.
And we may be one of the few couple of government employees still in the room at this stage.
And again, we thank you very much for being a part of this.
And we're delighted to be here, even though it's not necessarily everything has been so relatable to us.
Right.
But let me just say this, because we have an extremely aggressive tax dog group in our county. All of y'all probably know Mary Patrick, and I'm not saying anything I haven't said to her one-on-one in either Facebook, blog, email, phone, person. I'm our 10th county manager in 11 years, because they're just run off. We get hundreds of open records requests a year from Mary alone, let alone all the other entities that, you know, ask for things or other citizens that
just publish this stuff.
And that may not sound like a lot, because I think we're mostly surrounded by big entities that are more little. But it's a lot. And we have work to do. We have bills to pay, employees to pay, calls to return, citizens to help. And so it's a lot of burdens to do it. And we fundamentally believe in open government, we're citizens too. We would want to know what's going on. But what you're saying is right. It can't be this shotgun approach where you beat us up for everything all the time. You know, if the agenda isn't perfect, if the time at the top says 6, but down below it says work sessions at 5:15, don't beat us up for everything, because we're not robots. And, you know, we get asked for all the personnel records, all the check registers, all the checks, all the minutes, all the, everything we produce is asked for by our watchdog group. And so what we've tried to do is shove as much as we can onto our website, which is antiquated at best, and so it doesn't quite do the job. But if you don't want to have this adversarial relationship between your advocate groups, and I'm not against that in any way. I've worked with citizen advocates everywhere I've ever been. And your government, I think that's where we are. Right. Don't let it get to that.
Right. Well,
because you won't have a good government. You right. won't have people running for office that are good folks that would do a good job, because they don't want to fool with it.
And
you
also
have employees that want to come to work for the government for the same reason.
And the specific dynamics of this case, we're not going to be able to vet out and solve and iron out today. But I will tell you all this, is that everybody, government, every citizen, every media representative, every watchdog group needs to understand that we are the government. We are a self-governed people. And so that everything that government has and government does is ours, and you are citizens as well. So that's the culture that we're talking about and the mindset that we want to help incubate
and
create.
And it drives up costs if we're just cranking out open records request costs.
And we're paying for the cost as well.
But we're gonna
wrap up, guys.
I've got a 5-second tip that will boost. Okay. This applies to newspapers, blogs, whatever. Social media, absolutely correct. But social media isn't simply Facebook and Twitter. If you're not a power Reddit user, if you don't have Instagram, you don't have Tumblr, you're not reaching the younger generation. So make sure you use Reddit, especially, and that does go viral. I had a story on Andrew Hunt. I had over 100,000 people visit from because they got upvoted on Reddit.
Cool.
So use Reddit for your blogs, your newspapers, right. Please.
Right. Again, all of you have an immense amount of resource and information. And I hope at least that for those of you that are doing very similar kind of things in your community, you're walking away with the value of having a larger network now where you can share information and share ideas. I know that Holly and I not only talk about transparency and openness and access, we practice it too. So you always have unfettered access to whatever resources that we can help bring to bear. We're always willing to look at maybe commenting for your sites or for your publications if you would like that. Or writing a letter or picking up a telephone call, we'll do our best to provide resource and tool there as well. You have my email address. You have on both of our sites, on the transparency site, on the Freedom of Information or the foundation site, you've got full access to get in touch with us multiple ways. And so we hope that you continue to talk to one another. You continue to talk to us. Let me encourage you to get on our sites, to get on our blog, to get on to our Facebook and social media sites, and share information with us and be a part of that and grow this culture statewide. We're going to continue to do these sessions. What I would like for y'all to do as a homework assignment is go back and zip me or Holly an email and let us know what you would like to see in the next workshops that we do, where you would like to see them at as we move them around the state, and maybe you can even help provide a venue. And I will tell you this, if you can get an entire county and city government to come together and do an open government session, or that we can help mediate a conversation between watchdog groups and government, those are all the kinds of things that we think will bring value to help create this environment. So thank you all for being here. Thank you for being a part of the discussion. Hang around, network with each other, talk with us. All the materials that we have left are still for you. Don't think that it's just you got one, you can't get any more. If you've got people that you want to take books back to, we've got more. In fact, we've got truckloads more. So if you want the law enforcement book, if you want the red book, the cards, all that in the papers, all that information is free, available to you. And again, thank you all for being here.